Dear learners, I am Dr. A. Kalyani, working as an assistant professor in Shivashivani Institute of Management, Hyderabad. Today, we are going to learn about operations management basics. So here we have two terms, operations and management. So operations is converting inputs into outputs. Management is optimal utilization of resources in order to achieve the overall objective. What is overall objective? The overall objective can be converting the raw material into final output effectively as well as efficiently. Conversion of raw material into the final product using any transformation process. The transformation process can be physical, chemical, and thermal. So, for example, if we take physical transformation, then freezing of water, broken bottle, and here the fabric which is converted into garment. In physical transformation, we will be having the dimension or geometry or shape or size of that particular input is changed, but chemical composition remains the same. Coming to the example of chemical transformation, formation of curd from milk, burning of wood or coal, and rusting of iron. Here, there is a chemical reaction takes place and the composition of that particular input is entirely changed. Next, coming to the example of thermal transformation, it is the input is coal and water and thermal transformation takes place and the output we see is steam. Here, the conversion of water into steam by burning the coal. Next, here it shows the visual of operations management. In operations management, there are lots and lots of things that are intermingled with each other. Most of the topics are interrelated to one another. So here, we have requirements, input, output, resources, control, overseeing, strategy, planning, and cost. So the input is converted into output. So we have input-output relation. Resources can be inputs that we convert into the output. There are requirements based on the demand. We know how much to produce and what is to be produced. Then there is a control. For example, if we have production of manufacturing of cars. So per month we need to produce 500 cars, but due to some problems we are unable to produce 500. Instead of 500, the company has produced only 480 cars. Then we need to have a control on that particular thing, and next month we need to, or the company need to produce 520 cars instead of 500 cars to make up the less quantity which is produced in the last month. So coming to this transformation process, wherein we have input, transformation process, and output. So we have input and output. In between this, we have transformation process or conversion process. So this transformation or conversion process, process is very important in operations. So here we see inputs as land, people, capital, information, and materials. So using these inputs, we'll be getting the outputs, but in between there should be one transformation process. Through transformation process, we will be getting the outputs. The output may be goods or services. And here we have the output can be desirable. Desirable or defective. Or defective. So from output we will be getting the measurement and feedback. The feedback is measurements taken at various points in the transformation process. So by looking at the output, we will be having some information wherein if the goods are not as per the specifications, then the particular feedback will be going to the control department, wherein the control department is the comparison of feedback against previously established standards to determine if corrective action is needed. So if the output is not as per the requirement, what the control people or control process does is it has to check the actual requirements and the product produced. Then according to that, they will take the corrective action and it moves on to the inputs again to change it. Here we have what has to be the output. So the output should be related to the product. Second, what should be produced? The company has to decide what product has to produce has to be produced and how much, when to produce, and who will be producing the product. So here, who will be producing the product will come under input part, and how much we need to take care, how much when here what should be our output. So according to the output and according to the demand, we will plan how much to produce and when to produce. Then who will be producing that particular goods? So here in this particular process, we have inputs and this how much to produce and when to produce. Here we need to go for a concept by name material management. So this material management takes care of when should we order, how much to be ordered, and what type of materials to be ordered. In materials management, we have the latest trend by name MRP, material requirement planning, and MRP2, material resources, manufacturing resource planning, and other inventory techniques. Each and every organization need to follow the latest trends in manufacturing industry. No company can survive without understanding what is going on in the industry. So this is a visual representing the inputs, transformation process, and output. So here we have as input, capital, resources, materials, customers, information, and human resource management. The transformation process, here this is an organization wherein manufacturing will be taking place, hence the goods. Here these people are in service industry, hence they will provide services, and the outputs can be manufactured products like sofa, cameras, and car. So the operation managers have to take care of these three things like inputs, transformation process, and outputs. This is where the entire concept what to be produced, when to be produced, and how much to be produced, this everything will come into picture. Basically, the operations management deals with all these topics by name: product design and development, sales forecasting, facility planning and facility location, facility layout and plant layout, production planning, project scheduling, production control, quality, that is total quality management, total productive maintenance, statistical quality control, Six Sigma. Materials management, here we have inventory control and economic order quantity. Production models like just in time, Kanban, material requirement planning, and enterprise resource planning. Coming to the basic definition of operations management, the business function responsible for planning, coordinating, and controlling the resources needed to produce products and services for a company. So here earlier slides, we have discussed how much to produce, what is to be produced, when to produce. All these will be taken care by planning, coordinating, and controlling. And here the resources are men, material, machines, and other infrastructural resources, which we have seen in a diagrammatic representation, visual graphic, in the previous slide. Coming to the concept of operations management involves three basic terminology, that is, one is quality, second one is efficiency, and the third one is responsiveness to customers. So quality is goods and services that are reliable and perform correctly. So here quality is conforming to the specifications, or the product is produced according to the specifications given by the customer or the buyer. Efficiency, the amount of input to produce a given output. So we are producing number of output, is it related to input or not? So are we consuming extra amount of inputs to produce the output, or we are utilizing it prominently? Responsiveness to customers. These are the actions taken to respond to the customer's need. As soon as we produce the product, it reaches to the customers, and customers has to finally satisfy about that particular product. If not, we will be getting the feedback. According to that, we need to change our system. Coming to the basic objectives of operations management. So right quality, right quantity, predetermined time, and cost. For example, if we are, as a company or an organization, producing good quality products, meeting the required quantity, following or delivering the goods on time with a fair amount of predetermined cost, manufacturing cost, then we can say we are producing well, or we are managing our operations in the possible manner, best possible manner. So these are the basic objectives of, main objectives of OM, operations management. So there are intermediate objectives in operations management which help to achieve the main objectives by optimum utilization of various inputs, which we have discussed, like men, material, and machines, which in terms of stated in terms of machinery and equipment, materials, manpower, and supporting devices. Coming to operations management decisions, we have two types of decisions here. One is strategic decision and the other one is tactical decision. Strategic decision is a long-term decision and taken by the high-level management. These decisions set the direction for the entire company. They are broad in scope and long-term in nature. Coming to tactical decisions, these focus on specific day-to-day issues like resources needed, schedules, and quantities to produce. These are short-term and lower-level decisions. Coming to historical development of operations management, we have different timelines wherein we have evolved through all the different types of concepts, like industrial revolution started in late 1700s, coming to scientific management in early 1900s, human relations movement, management science, computer age, environmental issues, just in time, total quality management, re-engineering in 1980s, global competition, flexibility, time-based competition, supply chain management, which is a renowned concept in these days, is evolved during 1990s. Electronic commerce, that is e-commerce in 2000s, outsourcing and flattening of the world in 2000s, big data analytics from 2010 to present. Functions of an operational personnel. The operational person has to forecast the demand, arrange for the procurement of required factors of production, arranging for the services such as maintenance, storekeeping, material handling, inspection and quality control, utilizing effectively the factors of production and service facilities available to produce the product. Here, for an example, say automotive manufacturing, manufacturer of a cars, we have an assembly line. That is an example for facility. So we have assembly line, and from one end we start the assembling, and at the other end we'll be getting the output is fully assembled car. Here, number of stages are there, number of processes are happening in between the entire assembly line. So coming to the scope of operations management, the scope is that where we have to function, which area we need to function. Scope of operations management depends on the decisions we have seen earlier. We have seen the strategic level decisions and tactical level decisions, and the strategic level decisions are long term in nature and broad, given by the high level authority or high level management. Those are new product identification and design, process design and planning, facilities location and layout planning, design of material handling system, and capacity planning. These tactical or operation level decisions are taken by the lower level management. These may be production planning, production control, and other activities like inventory control, maintenance, safety, cost reduction, cost control, and work systems. Coming to operations management framework, operations management framework can be divided into 5 P's: product, plant, program, processes, and the last one is people. The first 2 P's, product and plant, have to do with the facilities location and layout planning. Program is related to the time, the process is related to management of facilities, and finally, people, we have to fit the job as per the person's capability so that the person is able to perform his task in the most effective and efficient manner without getting too much of fatigue and boredom. So we have to ensure the working environment for the people. These 5 P's are very important in operations management. Coming to frequently asked question, we have: what is operations management? What are the objectives of operations management? Different types of transformation process. What are the operations decisions? Explain the evaluation of operations management. Discuss the functions and scope of operations management. List the 5 P's of operations management framework. So here are the references from where the content has been taken. and thank you.